Hello everyone, hope you all are enjoying your day today. Since Venom Let There Be Carnage came out, and yeah, I saw it, don't worry, I'll make a review on it soon. But I decided to rewatch the first one to get the full picture. I actually saw this one in theaters and I remember loving it. So now I'm 18 years old, and what did I think of it now? Oh boy. It's okay. It's a watchable movie with some great moments, and it does its job to entertain the audience, but damn, is there a lot of stuff I hate about it too. I will be talking spoilers in this movie, so if you haven't seen Venom, stop watching this video and go watch it. If you have seen it or you don't give a shit about spoilers, glad you can stay. Let's get to the positives first. I really like Tom Hardy as Eddie Brock. I might be a little biased because I really love Tom Hardy's performance in almost every movie he's been in. Tom Hardy looks like he really cares about this movie and did a great job in the role. However, sometimes his line delivery is a bit weird, sounds raspy, almost awkward at times, his performance. And it's also very over the top as well, but you know, I guess that could be considered a positive for some people. Another thing I liked is the way they portrayed Venom in this movie. Venom's design in this movie is fantastic, very comic accurate, and badass, even without the spider logo. Venom is hilarious, threatening, badass, and relatable all in one. I thought it was a genius idea to have Venom talk to Eddie via his head and have Venom's head come out to talk to Eddie. Great stuff, and the bond they have is great and hilarious. The action sequences are great, with the standout being the apartment scene. There was one action scene I wasn't a big fan of, and I'll talk about that one in the final one. Like, it's the final battle. It was a good fight, don't get me wrong, but sometimes it feels very, very clunky in the early parts and messy, maybe perhaps a little too dark, as in color grading and lighting. Just looked very ugly, though it was awesome to see the two symbiotes combine into one. And the original score by Ludwig Göransson, I think that's how you pronounce the person's name. I'm pretty bad at pronouncing names, but the score was great and really added to the scenes. There's some great scenes in this movie, like Eddie telling Anne that he's scared of having Venom inside him, Eddie eating the lobster, which had me dying of laughter, the SWAT team fight. Yeah, and one of my personal favorites, Eddie eating tater tots and garbage, which which is my favorite scene in the movie. Now, I want to talk about my negatives, and there's a lot, so I'll start with the biggest one. The biggest one being that the villains, Riot and Carlton Drake, are some of the worst villains in a comic book movie in a while. Carlton Drake is legit one of the most boring and bland villains in a comic book movie. Sure, I get his motivation, but damn, Riz Ahmed's performance is so bland and lame. There's no passion in his performance, and it's probably because he was miscasted in my opinion. Like, for a villain like this, you need someone over the top and insane, and he feels very reserved at times when he could have been exploding, you know, like, have that weird dynamic, you know, like Tom Hardy be like over the top and have the villain be over the top as well. That's one of the positives of Venom 2. I'll get to that one when I review it, but just wanted to bring that up. Riot is cool, and that's it. He just has a cool design, and that's it. We know he's the leader, and he's just kind of the opposite of Venom. Nothing else. We don't know much about him, and yeah, I mean, that's it. We know what he wants to do, but it's just, why? Like, there's no reason. We don't care about him. Like, as a villain, we don't like, yeah, he's awesome, you know, like that. It's just bland. Also, the editing in this movie is also kind of choppy. Probably because they filmed it with an R rating in mind, but the studio cut it down. And it's fairly obvious when you see the final cut. Not a single drop of blood. and any blood that probably was added was probably cut out. And Venom biting heads off without blood is just a little weird. At least he bites the heads off. Doesn't bother me that much, but it's clearly wasted potential by the studio. Actually, Venom 2 will be PG-13, and I'm more disappointed that it's rated PG-13 since Carnage is a violent murderer in the comics more than Venom has already been. Anyways, back on topic. I think the first act of this movie is a mess, and I hate it. Sure, I get it. You gotta do all this stuff to establish Eddie Brock, but the romance is so bad. It's pointless, and it just shoves it in our faces. It feels 100% forced. The romance subplot was the second worst thing in this movie, the first being the villains. I'll give it this though, the love interest Anne has with this guy named Dan. Dan's actually cool, and I like that. It's a nice change of pace instead of having like the new boyfriend be a complete asshole and, you know, just be rude to Eddie. But Dan actually cares. I like that. It's a nice change of pace. But overall, this movie's just watchable. I could say at least it has a coherent story. You know, it goes in a line. Yeah. Just wish it was rated R. You know, and Tom Hardy said that his favorite parts of the movie were cut out. I want to see that cut. It sounds awesome. But, you know, I feel like I said enough about the movie, and I'm just going to give it a grade. In terms of comic book movies, I'm probably going to give it maybe a 5.5 or 6, somewhere around there. If I was grading it in terms of movie, I'd give it a 4 or 3. I just hope that the second one is better. Spoiler alert, it was. But I'll talk about it. Thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Jump. Pussy.
I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up? Please stand up. Please stand up. Cause I'm Slim Shady, yes, I'm the real Shady. All you other Slim Shadys are just imitating. So won't the real Slim Shady please stand up?